So, welcome back to another video on the DevScorch channel. In this video, we're going to talk about the comparison between Node.js and Vapor. The reason why I'm making a comparison is because in some Facebook groups and in some Discord servers as well, some people are always asking like, what should I use? Should I use Node.js? Shall I use Vapor? Do I need Python? Or shall I just use PHP? And I think I'm gonna make some comparison videos between the different frameworks and the different programming languages. So, and I wanted to start with Node.js and Vapor because that is a question I get a lot. So, introduction, Node.js and Vapor. Okay, so we're gonna talk first about Node.js. So, Node.js is based on JavaScript. JavaScript is an programming language. It's officially it's a front-end language. It's like executed by the browser. There's a great developers community. Something Node.js really has, it is like a really big developers community. You have like thousands of people using Node.js. It's really powerful, it's really amazing, and because of that it's also really great support. I think there's nothing that you do in Node.js that somebody can't help you with. There's always somebody who can help you with if you have an issue or if you want to do something. There's a lot of packages. So that mean that a lot of code that you maybe have to write yourself, you don't have to do that because you can use the packages for that. I think all the major payment authorities like PayPal, Stripe, and Bitcoin and stuff like that, they all support Node.js. It's widely supported by web hosts and web servers. Web servers normally support Node.js. Web host is like a little bit a different story. Before we started hosting our DevScorch by a hosting provider, we were under the impression that it supported Node.js because they were telling everybody they did, but they dropped Node.js support because of the stability on the servers or something. So always when you're gonna want to host a website, always make sure you check if they have support for your backend choosing. And because it is JavaScript, it's like really easy to learn. Node.js, I think, has one of the easiest learning curves in backend development. A lot of people say like, oh, PHP or something else. No, I think Node.js is the best to use if you want to learn it. If you want to learn backend development, you should start using Node.js before. So now we're going to talk about Vapor. Vapor is a Swift framework that allows us developers to build entire backends and APIs. It's based on the Swift programming language. Swift is officially from Apple, but Apple has like an open source variant. It's called Swift Neo. It's really powerful. We're gonna talk about that in a separate video as well. It has a growing developers community. The official Vapor developers community at the moment is like 140 people in the Discord channel. It's not really big or something, but it's a lot of people who are using Vapor for their daily use. It has growing support by online services. There are like hosting providers like Heroku, AWS. They all support Vapor now, or they support Swift in general. It's really easy to deploy. When you want to deploy a Vapor application, you do like two commands and it's deployed. It works, it builds, and it's amazing. It has really, really fast and high performance. Because Swift is a type safe language, it's really easy to catch errors and catch bugs and everything. So even when your API has a bug in it or an error, you really can catch it with a catch block. It's really, really amazing. Performance wise, Swift is, in my opinion, one of the best programming languages on the market. It's amazing how easy and how lightweight it is. It's amazing. And it's also really easy to learn. Swift is like the main programming language for all major Apple ecosystems. And when you are able to build an iOS app, building a backend is like riding a bicycle. You won't have to learn a lot of new stuff. So, which companies do use Node.js? So, Uber, the taxi app, uses Node.js. Netflix, Twitter, eBay, Fitbit, and DuckDuckGo. They all use Node.js as their backend. So, some companies like Nodes, Work, Applicodo, Scalpo, and of course DevScorch use Vapor. Of course, these companies are not really known at the moment, but they all use Vapor for the same reason as we do. It is because it's really easy, it's really lightweight, and it has amazing and high performance. Okay, so some pros and cons of Node.js. Of course, it's an amazing framework, but it also has some cons, of course. Pros is it's free to use, easy to learn, easy to deploy. It's widely supported, you have a lot of packages, easy to maintain, and it's relatively light to use on servers. Some cons, it can be cluttered. So when you're writing JavaScript, if you have experience with it, sometimes when I watch or when I see people at our company working with JavaScript, it's amazing. It looks like a hot garbage, the way how it's coded. And that is that's something that JavaScript is known for. The performance of Node.js is not always the best or on par with others. And that is because JavaScript is not really, it's not really a high performance language. It's not type safe. So type safe, as I stated before, it's not easy to catch errors or to catch bugs and stuff like that. That is why we use Swift. And it's single CPU bound. So let's say you have like a web server or an API server running two CPUs. No chance that you can use both CPUs at once. And that is also because of JavaScript, because JavaScript is not, or doesn't support multi CPU configurations. I don't think it's really hard to build in though. I don't understand why they didn't do it yet. Low computational power. It's not really good for making calculations and and working with really high data stacks. And asynchronous programming is the worst. So that are the pros and cons of Node.js. So pros of cons of Vapor: it's free to use, easy to learn, easy to deploy. It uses Swift. It has multi CPU support. It's really high performance, and it's low system usage. If you look at the Spectre API I built for our DevScorch platform, it is tested multiple times from multiple places with 10 million API requests at once. And it only uses 13 MBs of RAM and around 10-12% of CPU. So the low system usage and the performance is just amazing. Not a lot of support yet. That is because it's relatively new. I think Swift came out in 2014 as open source. And around 2015, 2016, developers starting to build frameworks for it to use as a backend. One other problem is it only works on macOS or Ubuntu distribution distros. So let's say you're working on Windows, there's no way that you can work with Swift or run it. And there's not a lot of third-party packages yet. The issue with that is like a lot of third-party companies like PayPal, Stripe, and so on, they don't support Swift officially yet. So we, the developers, have to write their own packages. There are some really good packages to be downloaded from the Vapor GitHub. Not a lot of third-party support yet, so that's a little bit similar to the packages issue. You have a lot of smaller developers who write packages for it so they can use it. It takes a little bit. The development community is not as big as the Node.js community. So if you're really somebody who wants to work only with big communities, you should use Node.js. If you don't care about stuff like that, you could use Vapor. So some small benchmarks. These are benchmarks from 2017. They are from medium.com, written by Remco, a really, really good developer as well. And as you can see, on the first one is perfect. Perfect is like it's like a Swift programming framework as well for backend development. I don't use it because I think Vapor is better. But as you can see, there is not a really big difference between between Regressed. But here you can see a little bit the performance when you do Regressed a second. Okay, so average latency. If there's something Node.js is really good in, it's like latencies. As you can see, when you do like an API request to Node.js, you have like 3.2 milliseconds. Of course, we as humans don't recognize MS because it just goes too fast. But let's say you do like 1 billion requests a day, for example. Then 3.2 MS is like, for the server it's okay, but it's really heavy workload. And as you can see, Vapor is holding back with 7 MS. It's like a difference. If you see it, it's like more than 2 times as slow. But that also totally depends on the way how it's coded. So it's with Node.js the same. I'm sure you can have the 3.2 MS. I'm sure you can have that. If you code your backend more properly, and if you code it more performant. So that is also with Vapor the same. Of course, I'm sure you can cut this in half, and maybe even cut that in half again if you write high performance code. It depends totally on the developer as well. So when could you use Node.js? So when you're already into JavaScript, so let's say you're a front-end developer, you're using HTML, CSS, JavaScript all day, I think using Node.js would be the logical choice, because it doesn't have a high learning curve, and when you already know JavaScript, you can easily build a Node.js application. When you want a high performance API, so as long as you have a server running on single socket, so single CPU, you can build high performance APIs. It totally depends on how you as a developer write code. I know people who build an iOS app, and when they send the iOS app to me, I can optimize it with 20% less performance. And I think that is with backend development the same. If you have a high performance code, you can build a high performance API. When you're just starting with backend development, so let's say you're a front end developer and you want to learn backend, Node.js is the way to go, the way to learn it, because you already know how to build a front end with JavaScript or maybe vanilla.js or something else, then choose Node.js. When you like to use a lot of packages, and when you like to be active in a big developers community. So that is a little bit why you could choose Node.js. When could you use Vapor? Well, when you're already an Apple developer using Swift, that's why I started to use Vapor, because I'm officially an Apple developer. I specialize in each Apple thing that is there. When you want a high performance API, in my opinion, and that's my holy opinion, Swift is twice as fast, 3 times as fast as Node.js when you write high performance code. And that totally depends on how you build your API. If you build an API with a lot of if else, or you use lots of catch block and loops and everything, of course the performance is going to be lower. But if you write high performance code, uses cases or structs and everything, I think you can build really fast applications in Vapor. Totally depends on what you're doing. When you have a multi-core CPU server, so let's say you have like an API server running two times a quad core or something, or 6 core, doesn't matter, and you really want to use one server for your API, I think Vapor is the way to go, because it's it has support for multiple processors, multiple cores and everything. And when you prefer low system usage, so as I stated before, the Spect API we use for our DevCourts platform only uses around 13 MBs of RAM of the 16 gigs, and it uses around 12-15% percent of the CPU, and that is on 10 million API requests on the same route. And that is something Vapor, for me personally, is like one of the better choices, because you can even build on a really low VPS with 1 or 2 cores, you can build a really fast Vapor API. Which one is safer? If you have seen my last video about about data difference in databases, you're probably going to see that I think that everything is safe, and that safety depends on the developers in 99% of the time. If you have developers who build safe applications and have good coding practices, you don't have to worry about which one is safer, because in my opinion, safety is always on the developers. If an API gets hacked, it's the developers who screwed up. That's my opinion, and it's not a popular opinion because a lot of companies are always like, no, it's a technology, or a lot of people, you know, when they tell me like, oh, Windows got hacked, or Netflix got hacked, for example, it's because of technology shit. No, it's not the technology, it's the developer working with the technology that makes it less safe. So, and then one last page about why we choose DevScore, or why we chat DevScore use Vapor over Node.js. It's because of the type safe Swift support. That is, it's for me really easy to catch an error. So let's say a user uses a route he shouldn't use, for example. Sometimes when you have Node.js application, then the application doesn't know what to do, and it crashes right away. With Swift, I don't have to build in a whole debugger system. I don't have to build in a whole catch block, or I don't have to build in a whole system to catch errors. The only thing I have to do is a catch block, and I only have to return an abort. And that is what type safe a little bit means. You can write code that doesn't crash very fast. Well, it uses Swift. I love Swift. It's highly scalable. So I wrote my API the way that if I want to run it on the second server, I only have to plug in the second server and the API will recognize it, and it will copy itself to the second server as well to run as a backup. Really high performance, I already explained that, low system usage and strong and clean syntax. If you see the syntax of my code, it's like really easy, and I think even a JavaScript developer can read it and knows what it does. So this is why we at DevScore choose Vapor over Node.js. I'm not saying that it's better than Node.js, but I just wanted to make a little comparison because it's a question a lot of people ask sometimes. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. If you have an idea about what you want me to make another video about, or if maybe you say like, oh, I would love to see a comparison between Swift and Android or something else, make sure to leave a comment, and I see you in the next video.